Om Sai Ram. Let us start today's prayer with chapter 12, Sai Lila's experiences of Kaka Mahajani, Dumal Pleader, Mrs. Nimonkar, Mule Sastri, a doctor. Now let us see in this chapter how devotees were received and treated by Baba. Saints' Mission. We have seen before that the purpose or object of divine incarnation is to protect the good and destroy the wicked. But the mission of the saints is quite different. To them, the good and the wicked are the same. First, they draw the evil doers and set them on the right path. They are the Agasti to destroy the Bhavasagar, the ocean of the only existence, or the sun to destroy the darkness of ignorance. The God dwells in the saints. In fact, they are not different from him. Our Sai is one of these who incarnated for the welfare of the devotees, supreme in knowledge and surrounded with divine aura. He loved all beings equally. He was unattached. Foes and friends, kings and paupers, all were same to him. Hear his leelas. For the sake of devotees, he gave his stock of merits and was ever alert to help them. But the devotees could never approach him unless he meant to receive them. If their appointed time did not come, they did not remember Baba and his leelas could not reach their ears. Then how could they think of seeing him? Some men desired to see Sai Baba, but they did not get any opportunity of taking his darshan till his Mahasamadhi. There are many such persons who desire for Baba's darshan was not thus satisfied. If these persons, believing in him, listen to his leelas, their quest for darshan will be to a great extent satisfied by the leelas. Even if some persons went there by sheer luck and took Baba's darshan, were they able to stay there longer? No, nobody could go there of his own accord, and nobody could stay there longer if Baba did not wish so. They could stay there so long as Baba permitted them to stay, and had to leave the place when asked to do so by him. So everything depended on Baba's divine will. Kaka Mahajani. Once Kaka Mahajani went to Shirdi from Mumbai. He wanted to stay there for 1 week and enjoy the Gokul Ashtami festival. As soon as he took Baba's darshan, Baba asked him, "When are you returning home?" He was rather surprised at this question, but he had to give an answer. He said that he would go home when he ordered him to do so. Then Baba said, "Go tomorrow." Baba's word was law and had to be obeyed. Kaka Mahajani therefore left Shirdi immediately. When he went to his office in Mumbai, he found his employer anxiously waiting for him. His munim, that the manager, suddenly fell ill, hence Kaka's presence was absolutely necessary. He had sent a letter to Kaka at Shirdi, which was redirected to him at Mumbai. Bau Sahab Dumal. Now listen to another story. Once Bau Sahab Dumal was going to Nipad for a case. On the way, he came to Shirdi, took Baba's darshan and wanted to proceed to Nipad immediately. But Baba did not permit him to do so. He made him stay at Shirdi for a week or more. In the meanwhile, the magistrate at Nippad suffered intensely from pain in his abdomen and the case was adjourned. Mr. Dhumal was then allowed to go and attend to his case. It went on for some months and was tried by 4 magistrates. Ultimately, Mr. Dhumal won the case and his client was acquitted. Mrs. Nimonkar. Mr. Nana Saheb Nimonkar, Wattender of Nimon and Honorary Magistrate, was staying at Shirdi with his wife. Mr. and Mrs. Nimonkar was spending most of their time in the masjid with Baba and serving him. It so happened that their son fell ill at Belapur and the mother decided with the Baba's consent to go to Belapur and see her son and other relatives and stay there for a few days. But Mr. Nana Saheb asked her to return the next day. The lady was in a fix and did not know what to do, but her god Sai came to her help. While leaving Shirdi, she went to Baba, who was standing in front of Sate's Wada with Mr. Nana Saheb and others, and prostrated at his feet and asked his permission to go. Baba said to her, "Go, go, quickly, be calm and unperturbed. Stay comfortably at Belapur for 4 days, see all your relatives and then return to Shirdi." How opportune was Baba's words. Mr. Nana Saheb's proposal was overruled by Baba's decree. Mule Shastri of Nasik. An orthodox Agnihotri Brahmin of Nasik, Mule Shastri, who had studied the 6 Shastras and was well versed in astrology and palmistry, once came to Shirdi to see Mr. Bapu Saheb Bhuti, the famous millionaire of Nagpur. After seeing him, he and others went to see Baba in the masjid. Baba bought various fruits and other things from vendors with his own money and distributed them to the people present in the masjid. Baba used to press the mango on all sides so skillfully that when Baba sucked it, he got all the pulp at once in his mouth and could throw away the seed. Plantains were peeled off by Baba and the pulp was distributed to the devotees, while the skins were retained by Baba for himself. Mule Shastri, as a palmist, wanted to examine Baba's palm and asked him to extend his hand. Baba ignored his request and gave 4 plantains to him. Then they all returned to the wada and Mule Shastri bathed, wore fresh clothes and started his routine duties, Agnihotra, etc. Then Baba as usual started for Lendi and said, "Take some geru," that means a red miry substance, "use it to dye cloths in saffron color. We shall today don saffron colored cloth." None understood what Baba meant. Then after some time, when Baba returned and preparations for the noon aarti were being made, Bapu Saheb Jog asked Mule Shastri whether he could accompany him for the aarti. He replied that he would see Baba in the afternoon. Baba sat on his seat, was worshipped by the devotees, and aarti commenced. Then Baba said, "Get some dakshina from the new Nasik Brahmin." Bhuti himself went to the wada to get the dakshina, and when he gave Baba's message to Mule Shastri, he was sorely perplexed. He thought in his mind, "Thus, I am a pure Agnihotri Brahmin. Why should I pay dakshina? Baba may be a great saint. I am not his dependent. But since a great saint like Sai Baba was asking for a dakshina through a millionaire-like booty he could not refuse. So, leaving his routine unfinished, he started with booty for masjid, thinking himself holy and the masjid otherwise. He remained at a distance and after joining his palms threw flowers at Baba from there. Then lo, all of a sudden he saw not Baba but his late guru Golap Swami there. He was wonderstruck. Could this be a dream? No, it was not, as he was wide awake. But how could his late Guru Golap be there? He was speechless for some time. He pinched himself and thought again, but could not reconcile to the fact of his late Guru Golap being in the masjid. Ultimately, leaving aside all doubt, he went up, fell at his Guru's feet, and then stood there with folded hands. Other people sang Baba's Aarti while Mur Shastri chanted loudly his Guru's name. Then, casting off all pride of caste and sacredness, he fell at his Guru's feet and closed his eyes. When he got up and opened his eyes, he saw Baba asking for Dakshina. Seeing Baba's blissful form and his inconceivable power, Mul Shastri forgot himself. He was extremely pleased. His eyes were full of tears of joy. He again saluted Baba and gave the Dakshina. He said that his doubt was removed and he was his own guru. On seeing this wonderful leela of Baba, all the people, including Mul Shastri, were so much moved and they realized the meaning of Baba's words. Bring Geru, we shall then saffron colored cloths. Such is the wonderful leela of Baba. A doctor. Once a mamlatdar came to Shirdi with a doctor friend of his. The doctor said that his deity was Ram and that he would not bow before a Mohammedan, and so he was unwilling to go to Shirdi. The mamlatdar replied that nobody would press him to bow down, so he should come and give the pleasure of his company. Accordingly, they reached Shirdi and went to the masjid for Baba's darshan. All were wonderstruck to see the doctor going ahead and saluting Baba. They asked him how he forgot his resolve and bowed down to a Muslim. Then the doctor replied that he saw his beloved deity Ram on the seat and he therefore prostrated himself before him. Then, as he always saying this, he again saw Sai Baba there. Being dismayed, he again said, "Is this a dream? How could he be a Mohammedan? He is a great yoga sampanna, full of yoga avatar." Next day, he made a vow and began to fast. He absented himself from the masjid, resolving not to go there until Baba blessed him. 3 days passed, and on the fourth day, a close friend of his from Khandesh turned up, and with him, he went to the masjid for Baba's darshan. After the salutation, Baba asked him whether anybody had gone to call him that he had come. Hearing this vital question, the doctor was moved. The same night he was blessed by Baba and he experienced bliss supreme in his sleep. Then he left for his town where he remained in the same state for a fortnight. Thus his devotion for Sai Baba increased manifold. The moral of all the stories mentioned above, especially that of Mul Shastri, is that we should have firm faith in our Guru and on none else. More leelas of Sai Baba will be described in the next chapter. Bow to Sri Sai. Peace be to all. Om Sai Ram.